Hi, everyone. Good afternoon. How many of you have ever heard about Kano, just so I know who's in the building? Great. It's about 90%. No, I'm kidding. And how many of you have ever built a computer? Raise your hand. Okay, it's about 95%. That's fantastic. Okay, so I have a pretty engaged audience here. I'd like to share with you the story about what we're doing and why we're doing it and why we think it's interesting. I'm sure some of you here have children at the age group that might be relevant for us, and if not, then maybe someone else on your wider network. So we started Kano about 4 years ago, and really it started with a challenge from a six-year-old, Mika. Now he's about 10. And we gave Mika a computer board, and we told him what he thinks it is, and he said he thinks it's a computer. And we told him, what would you like to do with it? He said, well, I'd like to build my own computer, but it needs to be simple and fun as Lego, so no one has to teach me. And we thought, well, why would a six-year-old in a world where, you know, you have magical devices like iPhones, tablets, etc., would want to actually, you know, put together his own computer? And so we kind of looked at what exists out there in the world, and we realized that, you know, there are about 120 million babies being born every year. Out of them, 110 are born in non-Western countries. And globally, there are about almost 2 billion children below the age of 15, which was pretty overwhelming. And again, most of them are in Asia, in Latin America, in Africa, some of the youngest populations on Earth. And we thought, you know, in a world where connectivity is ubiquitous and technology is in abundance, you know, we would like to empower Mika's generation so they can make, learn, and play with technology, not just consume on iPads or on iPhones and swipe their finger and for their parents to say, oh my God, my child is so smart because they're only 3 years old and they've managed to operate an iPad on their own. So that's what we set out to do.
Hi, I'm Nalan, I'm Nia's dad.
Hi, I'm Nia and I'm 9 years old.
Nia is naturally creative. She's like awesome at English and writing poems. She's got a poetry website and stuff. The unboxing was very cool. She was more interested in just ripping the box open, getting everything out and trying to build it.
With drawing, you can draw it really easily, but with coding, it takes you longer and it challenges you.
I think, you know, creativity, I think, is super important. It's important for my daughter, and I think technology is like another avenue and way in which they can express that.
It's really fun because I also discover new things with it, how to make circles combine and things like that. I like making things on it.
So really, Kano is a computer that kids put together by themselves, and then after they put it together and get a sense of ownership that they've just built their first computer, they learn to code with it, and they can make artwork and games and sounds. And then the most exciting part is actually taking what they've created and share it on a social network that is called Kano World, where today we have, you know, over 60,000 young creators of all ages sharing all of their cool things that they've made with code and for other kids all over the world to see. Some of the things are more exciting, some of the things are using different programming languages, and it's not about teaching them to code. It's about showing them that they can do anything that is fun that they used to do every day and actually using code to do it and give them the power to shape what they want with technology and not just kind of, you know, move things. But on a higher level and on a bigger picture, you know, that is sort of the opportunity we're tapping. There are millions of millions of millions of devices, and there are billions of people, and they don't really know how to use technology in a much more constructive and appealing way. And, you know, we're in these kind of very weird times where we're talking about machine learning and artificial intelligence, and, you know, language has evolved over millions of years, and now the question is, how can you introduce language of programming, and then ultimately, moving forward, also, how do you communicate with machines that are going to be even more sophisticated? So we believe that by introducing that technologies as early as possible to children, it's going to empower them to be a much more creative generation in a world of technology abundance. And we have some great sort of feedback from Classroom. This is a video that we've done a year ago with a great champion of the company, Martin Sorrell from WPP.
I think it's really important that kids learn code. What Yonatan's doing at Kano and what Kano stands for is really important. It really has a purpose. If you can unleash, particularly in this case, young talent, there's all this sort of intelligence and ability which has laid relatively untapped in previous generations. Kano is immensely powerful because this is going to alter the horizons of very young people. By connecting them to the internet, it opens up, you know, the library of the world, if you like.
There's all these kids, they have dreams and they have aspirations, but they don't really have the tools. They have magical devices, you know, like tablets and Android phones, but they don't really have a sneak peek inside these machines. So we wanted to unlock that power, give them something that they can play with, make with, and eventually also learn how they can control these tools and really give them something that they can shape their own future with. First of all, how many of you have ever built their own computer? How many of you want to build a computer today? That is a great answer. So we're ready to go. Now build a computer. Almost everything that exists today, code will be part of. You know, 10 years from now, we will definitely want to be in a place where Kano and other companies really make it possible for this generation to rethink and reshape for the better the world we live in. And it doesn't matter where they are geographically, what matters, do they have access to the right tools? And if they don't, how can we give them these magical tools? And what will they do with it to shape and empower their own community, their own country, and eventually maybe the entire global economy? So this is only the beginning for us. And over the last 2 years, we've sold, designed, sold, and delivered over 100,000 of our computer kits to kids of all ages in over 80 countries, right out of East London here. And we have an exceptional team that deals with the supply chain in China. And recently, we've introduced three new computers, a camera kit, a pixel kit, and a speaker kit. So essentially what we're building is a creative computing platform where kids of all ages can make really, really cool things that they've never been able to do before, and on the way, learn about coding and get ready for a future. These are sort of quickly some of our indicators of success so far, you know, winning incredible design awards, raising over $20 million in capital from really incredible individuals and institutional investors globally. And you know, we feel like there's a lot to do in a world where 2 weeks ago, over 50% for the first time of world population got connected to the internet. We want to give them the tools to be ready for the future, to make, learn, and play with technology, not just consume, and be super children. Thank you.